Today our topic is about persons. There are three types of persons. It may be in English and in Telugu also. Telugu lo gaani English lo gaani persons mood rakal untar persons. First person, second person, third person. First person, second person, third person here. First person, I, we. I singular, we plural. Even I, first person, I singular, first person, we plural. Subject ga betti, vakyalu chesinappudu verb lo konni markulu vastundayi. Aa markulu ee roju manam gamanistam. First person, I singular, we plural. Second person, you singular, you plural. Neevu, meeru, singular, plural. Third person, singular, again plural. In third person, he, she, it, rabbit, tiger, lion, the sun, the moon, the earth, Rama, Seva, Hari, these are all third person singular. Third person ante manushule undalsina avasaram ledu. Nenu, neevu tappa migatha vishayalu edi maatladane third person avutundi. Adi moonu gurinchi gaani, sunnu gurinchi gaani, ramunu gurinchi gaani, krishnunu gurinchi gaani, except I and you, all are third persons. All are third persons. There are third person singular and there are third person plural. They are both, there are. Third person singular, third person plural. Third person singular example, he, she. Except I and you, all are third person. In third person, both singular and plural number. Singular and plural numbers. See, here we see. Now, we put I and we as subject and try to frame sentences. Here, I eat roti every day. I eat roti every day. We eat roti every day. See, first person. I eat roti every day, we eat roti every day. These are habitual actions. These actions take place every day. These are habitual actions. Second person, you. Singular, you. Plural, you. In second person also, the same thing. You eat roti in singular, in plural also, you eat roti. Here these are subject words. The sentence begins with the subject word. Here this word. You eat roti every day. You eat roti every day. Now we will go to the third person. In third person singular, he eat is equal to eats. In third person singular, it is equal to eats. He, third person singular, he eats roti every day. She eats roti every day. It eats roti every day. Rama eats roti every day. Hari eats roti every day. Everyday actions, you see, everyday actions, that is habitual thing. Now we will go to third person plural. Here we are using they as the subject word, the beginning word of the sentence. We are using they eat roti every day. They eat roti every day, because this is plural, don't say eats. They eat roti every day. Rama and Hari, both are plural, you see. Rama, more than one. Rama and Hari eat roti every day. Because this is plural, third person plural. సీతా అండ్ రామ, సీతా అండ్ రామ ప్రే ఎవ్రీడే, ప్రే ఎవ్రీడే. డోంట్ సే సీతా అండ్ రామ ప్రేస్ బికాస్ దిస్ ప్లూరల్, దే ఇస్ ప్లూరల్, రామ అండ్ హరి ఇస్ ప్లూరల్, సీతా అండ్ రామ ఈజ్ ప్లూరల్. దీస్ ఆర్ ఆల్ ప్లూరల్స్, ప్లూరల్ వర్డ్స్. వెన్ యూ యూజ్ థర్డ్ పర్సన్ ప్లూరల్ వీ షుడ్ నాట్ యూజ్ ఎస్ ఈట్స్, యూ షుడ్ ఆల్వేస్ యూజ్ ఈట్. దే ఈట్ రోటీ, రామ అండ్ హరి ఈట్ రోటీ ఎవ్రీ డే, సీతా అండ్ రామ ప్రే ఎవ్రీ డే. That's all, this plural, that is the difference. In third person singular only, eats we get. Eats? We get. In plural we get only eat. See, that is the difference here. Between only here, in the persons, the main thing I am telling you, in nutshell. The difference is only in third person singular. In third person singular, We add yes or es to the simple present tense. To the simple, we use yes or es to the simple present tense. I will give examples. Now we will go to tenses, main tenses. To understand persons elaborately, we must know what is simple present tense, simple past tense and simple future tense. These are the main tenses in English and Telugu also. Both the Bhavishyat Vartaman Kalalu. Present tense, simple present tense, simple past tense, simple future tense. These are very, very important. With these three words, simple present tense, with the three tenses, simple present tense, simple past tense and simple future tense, we can do miracles. That's all. See, you need, there are 12 tenses in English. We need not know all the tenses. Anyhow, I will teach all 12 tenses in the later part of the grammar. Now we will see only these three important tenses. Because these are meant simple, this is simple. Why it is named as simple present tense? It is simple to understand. Why it is named as simple past tense? It is very simple to understand. Simple future tense, it is future tense is very simple to understand. That is why simple is added. Simple is added. Here, sing, we'll take verbs. Only the tenses are only for the verbs. The tenses are only for the verbs. Here, we will take the verb sing. Sing, past tense, simple past tense, sang. Simple future tense, will sing or shall sing. Will sing or shall sing. You see, in present day English, in formal English, not in informal English, old English, there was difference. Now also difference, there is subtle difference between will and shall. Very, very subtle difference. Now slowly, the difference between will and shall is disappearing. Now you must think will is equal to shall. You must think as will is equal to shall. The difference is slowly disappearing. That's all. You see, now we will go to again another verb, drink. Drink, simple present tense. Drank, simple past tense. Shall drink or will drink is simple future tense. Shall drink or will drink, simple future tense. Now, watch, simple present tense. Watch, simple past tense. Will watch or shall watch. Will watch or shall watch is future, simple future tense. Now, we will call it as future simple. Or we simply call simple future tense. Simple future tense, that's all. Now, I will give 10 examples on this, so that it will be better for your understanding. Now we observe the verbs here. I drink coffee every day. Here the subject is in first person singular. First, I drink coffee every day. There is no change. There is no yes or yes to this word. We drink coffee every day. We drink coffee every day. Here there is no yes or yes to it. We drink coffee, first person singular, అండ్ ఫ్లోర్లో ఆల్సో వీఆర్ యూజింగ్ ది సేమ్ బెర్ డ్రింక్ ఇన్ సెకండ్ పర్సన్ ఆల్సో ది సేమ్ థింగ్ హ్యాపెన్స్ సి యూ డ్రింక్ కాఫీ ఎవ్రీ డే సింగులర్ సెకండ్ పర్సన్ సింగులర్ యూ డ్రింక్ కాఫీ ఎవ్రీ డే మీరు తాగుతారు ప్రతిరోజు నీవు తాగుతావు ప్రతిరోజు కాఫీ అన్నా డ్రింకే మీరు తాగుతారని ప్లోరల్ వాడినా యూ డ్రింక్ కాఫీ ఎవ్రీ డే అన్నా కూడా డ్రింకే వస్తుంది దేర్ ఇస్ నో చేంజ్ ఇన్ ఫస్ట్ పర్సన్ అండ్ సెకండ్ పర్సన్ బట్ వేర్ ఆర్ ది చేంజెస్ ఇన్ థర్డ్ పర్సన్ సింగులర్ థర్డ్ పర్సన్ సింగులర్ యు సీ హియర్ షీ హీ రామ థర్డ్ పర్సన్ దే థర్డ్ పర్సన్ నాట్ Except you and I, all others are third persons. Except you and I, or it may be animal, creature, it may be man or woman, it may be girl or child, anything. If you are talking about them, they are considered to be third person, thingless and plurals. Here, see, here, now, she drinks coffee every day. Here you see, we are adding she, third person. Not I and you. Here the subject word is she. She drinks coffee every day. Third person singular. Again another he. It is also except I and you. He is the third person. Udo manshi. Ekkada unde manshi third person ante. You see, he drinks coffee every day. He drinks coffee every day. The difference is only here. See, Rama. We are talking of Rama here. Except I and you. The third person is Rama. Now the third person is Rama. We are now talking about Rama. Here subject is Rama. Rama drinks coffee every day. Third person. Rama also third person singular. That's why Rama drinks coffee every day. We are adding here yes to the simple present tense. To the simple present tense. Again, they drink coffee every day. Third person plural. They. There is the only drink we get. We should not use drinks. They drink coffee every day because this is third person plural. The subject is in third person plural. They drink coffee every day. Rama and Hari also plural because two persons are here. Rama and Hari. Rama and Hari drink coffee every day. Drink coffee every day. Now we will discuss about simple past tense. See, what is the simple past tense of drink? Drank. See, I drank coffee every day. See, I drink coffee every day. These are all what in simple present tense. These are habitual actions. Every day the actions go on. I drink coffee every day. We drink coffee every day. You drink coffee every day. You drink coffee every day. She drinks coffee every day. He drinks coffee every day. Rama drinks coffee every day. They drink coffee every day. Rama and Hari drink coffee every day. These are plural because. Now in drank, there is no change at all. We need not think of persons when you use simple past tense. Simple past tense. You see, I drank coffee yesterday. We drank coffee yesterday. You drank coffee yesterday. You drank coffee yesterday. She drank coffee yesterday. He drank coffee yesterday. Rama and Hari drank coffee yesterday. They drank coffee yesterday. Rama and Hari. See, once again. Rama and Ravi drank coffee yesterday. In simple past tense, there is no change. We must use simple present tense as it is. What is the simple past tense? This is drink is the simple present tense. What is the simple past tense of drink? Drank. While using drank, there is no change. We need not see about the subject. We need not see about the subject. In every sentence, you will get drank yesterday, drank. In the same way, in simple way, when we use simple future tense, I will take tea tomorrow. I will drink coffee tomorrow. We will drink coffee tomorrow. You will drink coffee tomorrow. You will drink coffee tomorrow. She will drink coffee tomorrow. He will drink coffee. Sita will drink coffee tomorrow. Rama and Hari will drink coffee tomorrow. They drink coffee tomorrow. The same thing. No change in the simple past tense and simple. The change is only in the simple present tense. Drink is equal to drinks. Drink is equal to drinks. డ్రింక్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు డ్రింక్స్ ఇన్ సింపుల్ ప్రజెంట్ టెన్స్, గో ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు గోస్ ఇన్ సింపుల్ ప్రజెంట్ టెన్స్, టేక్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు టేక్స్, గివ్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు గివ్స్ ఇన్ సింపుల్ ప్రజెంట్ టెన్స్. ఎస్, దట్స్ ఆల్.